My topic is emotional healing, and let me introduce myself. I am Varshha Paatkar, and I'm a very regular speaker here, and I really thank Health Talks and Dr. Malpani and everyone who are here for listening to me every month, and all the people who are watching it on YouTube in India, outside India. So thank you to all of them. And today my topic is going to be on emotional healing, but through this I am going to explore the more scientific part and the consciousness part connected with this emotions. So it's will help you to understand why healing is required, because I have seen that many people just learned healing but they don't understand the aspects of it. So I'm going to try to cover in this short session. So let's start. The first slide comes with the love. Okay, so let's understand the definition of love. What is love? We can be interactive in this way. What is love?
It's an emotional binding.
Okay. It's a basic love.
Basic
emotion.
It's a basic emotion. And anything else? There are various ways we love.
It's the language of the heart, it's not language of the brain.
Okay. Anything else you want to say?
Through which we bind with everybody.
Yes. Love can be said as something that we bind with emotions, or love can also be said that it releases our emotions. So it both the ways, it's an aspect how you look at it. If we look from human consciousness level, we'll always feel love, that we bind it to people. But if we look at the spiritual or a higher consciousness aspect, love is a way which transcends us into different realities and different modalities, and love is actually God. It is omnipresent aspect which is there in everyone. We do not need to find love. Many a times people say that, how do I find my love in the life? I said, you don't have to find, it's there inside you. You need to just open your inner realities and what you are. You need to explore yourself, to explore the biggest aspect of you for what you have come here for, and that is love. That is, and this love is actually very divine, but we have connected with the human consciousness or the human aspect of it, and mainly we have connected the love to the human relations or various relations that we have in our lives. Okay, but let's look at the other part of it. Is love also has an expressions? Okay, but when we are talking about emotions and emotional healing, means people look at the other aspect of it. That means a person requires only when he is sad emotional healing, but there are times when expressions speak different languages. Your eyes have different ways through which it speaks. An expression can be an extension of a person or a soul, and or expression can be a barrier for a soul, that one restricts his total potentiality of what he or she is. So eyes are the way one where one can express, and it's not bad to cry. It's very good to cry. It's a way of emotional freedom. And when we become very heavy and sometimes we can't take it, we just cry. And many a times it's said that crying is shown as a weak aspect. I mean, that's a very wrong conditioning. I would say that when you feel in happiness also, people cry. When people are very happy, one expression that they give is cry. That's also a very nice expression. And when they are sad, they also cry. So it's a form of expression. It should not be dealt in a way that a man or a woman becomes weak when he or she cries. It's not like that. And if you see, the whole history of a man is in his brain, and the contents of the brain are reflected in his eyes. There are many songs where you see in Hindi or you know, Hollywood songs or anyone, they speak a lot of eyes. You know, it depends on the person who writes the song, who's a very good lyricist. I mean, there are so many Hindi songs and which talk about the eyes, you know, many. Even in recent times also, I've seen many songs which are very, very beautifully written. If you observe the way they describe it, it's a beautiful expression, okay? And that comes to the love of the self, okay? And that is where the love is connected with that emotion. And the eyes are the index of the mind, because everything is captured by the eyes. You know, that's why we said that if you need to connect with the inner reality, please shut off your eyes. That means, that's why it said that while meditating, you need to shut your eyes. That's where we disconnect with the outer reality. We start connecting with our inner realities, and that's where we start looking at ourselves, that is our soul. Okay, so it said that the eyes are the index of the mind, the character that we build, the habits that we have, and the soul of a person. So it's a beautiful way we can express. So crying is not bad. So if you want to cry at times, even when you're happy, you should. Okay, you should clear it out, whatever is there, because sometimes eyes capture those emotions, and if it's not clear, it stays back as a memory. Now where it stays, that also I will explain it to you. Let's look at the other slide. Moods. Okay, these are the masks that we carry, you know, all the time we carry. And these masks are made by perceptions that we build. Sometimes our eyes capture something, and if it's not cleared from time to time, these images are created in your brain. And when you connect with similar situations or similar incidents, you start having that mask, or you start having those masks. And these are nothing but your moods. These are temporary, these are not permanent. These are the way we reflect ourselves. Sometimes we reflect ourselves as a sad person, sometimes we reflect ourselves as a happy person. And many a times I suggest people that please don't see a lot of emotional serials, because your eyes see those, they capture the pain of the person, and they start reflecting in your inner senses. So please don't belong to a story which doesn't belong to you. Don't capture all those moods. You can actually spend time more with your yourself and allow your emotions to heal. So there's a beautiful movie. I always give examples of movies, because many a times, I think 70-80% of the people love watching the movies. But I seldom see people, they enjoy the movie, but they don't find messages in that. Because our life is itself is like a movie. But when you're watching a movie, also you can find a lot of messages. It's such a beautiful movie. Okay, let's come back to this slide. And I was just discussing about this movie. Its name was Tamasha. And the entire movie, if you watch it now, like now that I've told you, it is based on unconscious mind. It is based on whatever memories the person has had since his childhood. So the childhood is a very important aspect of a person. And if it is shaped in a proper way, the entire future of the soul, whoever it's a male child or a female child, it will be shaped in a better way. And I would also request a lot of teachers, because they play a very important role in the emotions of the child. Because luckily I have had very good teachers, and who promoted the good aspects of me, and who highlighted the good qualities of me. And those were the days. But still I would request a lot of teachers to take interest in this, because the emotions of the child, if in that space, if not clear, if he's happy, sad, or if he has some problems, if it's not clear, later on the personality starts reflecting it. So I would advise the teachers also to look into it. But let's come back to that movie. What I was trying to tell you is that person has various masks, because his childhood has been very traumatic. He starts holding different masks. He goes somewhere outdoor they have it all together, different story. But when he starts connecting with his inner reality, his emotions start playing a very big role. He shuts off his real blueprint, what he has come from. His real blueprint was something different, and the emotion stopped him from connecting with his real life blueprint, whatever was his real movie. And then some incidents happen in his life which helping to connect with his reality, and in 3 hours his entire life changes. But we have been given like 70-80 years of our life in human consciousness, and many a times we live in this life with a altered consciousness. That means it's not awakened. That means 80 years just go, we take another birth, we take another life, and it just keeps on happening. So if we start igniting, like in the movie which goes on for three and a half hours, if a person can change, I mean, we've got 70 years. I mean, we definitely can take the opportunity and heal each and every emotions. Let that emotion come to a higher frequency. If it's sad, let it change to happiness. If it's a pain, let it change it to a pain-free thing. At least that things we can do, not change the frequency of the emotions that you've been having. So then the moods will not be there. We don't have to wear these masks continuously, because nowadays we see this mask on everyone, and sometimes we start capturing people's masks because we start liking them. And if they are doing something, we should also do something. Robbing someone's emotions. So the masks that you're wearing are not yours, because the emotions sometimes you have captured from someone, or it is there in your long-term memory and it has not been healed. Then another very nice slide that I got, the human is a clone of his emotions, and whatever is there, he just tries to get it out in his ways he expresses himself. So you can see various emotions are there, like hate, worse, mad, worry. So he tries to absorb that during his lifetime. Sometimes these incidents happen a lot in the childhood, and they start coming out when he starts becoming a teenager, or he starts growing up and it starts reflecting in his life. So human is like a clone of his emotions, whatever he has absorbed. Okay, so you can see it's a beautiful image. So it shows stickers on yourself, and this is the way, because I'm artistic and I'm an artist, so I try to find out good images which reflect the words that I say. So you can see the person here is very common, but you can see his expressions, none of the expression is same. These are the different moods that we create throughout the day, when we are happy, when we are sad, when we are angry, when we are low, when we are very, very excited. But if you see the next slide, the people here are different. They are of different colors, different styles, different ages. But one thing is common in this. What is that?
Smile.
That's the happiness aspect of your emotion. So even though we belong to different generations, or we belong to different lives, or we have different situations in our life, but one emotion we can constantly try to hold throughout the day. Now I can give you one secret, is if you can to hold this emotion throughout the days, plan your entire day. Before you start your day, ideally you can do it one day before, or if you get up early in the morning, like 5 o'clock or something, you can plan your day the way you want. And don't allow anyone's emotions to dominate that day. And I will tell you that if you do that, actually that you will have these smiling quotients more on your face. And I've done this experiment with many people, and many people have said that one thing it has changed is the connect with themselves. They have helped to connect with their own realities and help them to manage the time also. And less of stress, more of happiness. In fact, in those corporate lives also, it has helped them to be less stressful and more smiley and happiness, and having more higher emotional quotients and higher frequencies than lower. Because if you are having a higher emotional vibrations, these will create very strong energies which can attract very happy situations to you. So you can see a change in your business, in your career also. So try to have these. So plan your day either one day before, or either a little earlier in the morning, so you can have this expression throughout the day. And that's the best thing that one can carry. That's one of the best ornament that one can carry, is the smile, is the happiness emotion. Okay. Another part is how that can happen is with the balance. How balance is your life? Balance doesn't mean in the form of money, fame, it comes with the balance of emotions, not even relations. Okay. Balance comes with how balanced you are with the emotions. How balanced or how connected with you are with your own emotions, which emotions is high on you. Okay, how many people take that much time to connect with their realities? How much time you give to your own self? It doesn't need to give 2 hours or 3 years. If 3 hours, even 5 minutes you give to your own consciousness, the awareness will start. Your awareness will start building, and your emotions will start connecting with you. It will start talking with you. Okay. Then when you say that yes, you take the entire responsibility of that emotion, the emotion will no longer have the hold on you. If you are having a specific problem or emotional problem, or required for this, and a balanced brain can also give us the optimal you know, ways of looking at life, more of vitality and more of happiness, and better management of your body functions also. Let's look at the emotional aspect of it, like how emotions can affect your brain. Now you can see the two diagrams, these are thermal images. One is a stressed brain and one is an optimal functioning. Now this optimal functioning can be because of balanced emotions, a healthy lifestyle, meditations, and any type of holistic way of life that you're living. So you can see the other part of the brain is more, has more of holes, and is more depleted. You can see it's more stressed. Now this can be because of any elements also, or any brain disorders also. So but your other part you can see is more of an optimal functioning. So when you balance your emotions, now the various ways you can balance your emotions, you can see your brain starts performing in a better way, or in vital ways which is required for your body. Even your lifestyle starts changing when your both sides of the brain balance. One is the left and one is the right. Ideally we require a balance. It's not always has to be left, not always has to be right. Okay, when you are right, women are said to be right sided and the men are said to be left sided, because men are logical thinkers and women are more emotional. So on the emotional side, it's has to be the right.
Not necessary.
I'm just saying, it's a saying, but ideally what we require is a balance. Yeah. Because nowadays what has happened is the women have started working, so they are more of a logical minded, and the men sometimes have become more emotional aspect of it, but it varies from person to person.
Okay.
See the various ways. Okay, so you can see your brain cells also, when they are stressed, they start shrinking. You know, there is no life force there, or there is no energy. Why healing is required is because it increases the life force or the energy in you. Because naturally, if we try to do it, we have to do various layers of meditation, very deep meditation. Even meditation can get, but to get out faster out of trauma in your life or any incidents in your life, healing. Okay.
Look at the slide here. You can see even your neurons have started shrinking, which is giving you additional stress. If a normal, normally you can see at the other part where it's going. Showing properly functioning, and the other part if you're seeing it's more shrunk. So all these, your body of is made up of these 100 billion neurons. So if your potential message inside your brain is very wrong, or if your emotions are very wrong, like these the clone images are very wrong, then your brain will start absorbing that, and the internal dialogue through all your neurotransmitters will be all stressed. That's how you will start attracting different diseases in your body. So that's why sometimes for the people, they are very confused that what they should be doing. Though their inner dialogue is very, very good, their energy is very good, but because of the emotions, and these emotions not being healed, the brain has a very confused state of understanding. It is either altered or either it's not at all awakened. So it's a very confused state of understanding it. So let's look at the scientific part, is where these emotions will be stored. It is the hippocampus. It's a part of a system that directly directs many body functions. It's a limbic system, and it's located in the medial temporal lobe near the center of the brain. It's actually very close to the pineal gland, which is called as a master gland, where everything, if you can open that pineal gland, or it's connected with the third eye, you can actually start everything, attracting everything in your life. And the hippocampus is where it's involved in the storage of long-term memory, which includes all the past knowledge and experiences. Now, past knowledge and experience doesn't mean that it belongs to the past life. It can be, like I said, it can belong to your childhood, or it can belong to something in the womb also, that how the mother and the child have the conversation. Even the emotions can come from that level. I have done past life regression for many people, and I have seen that some emotions have gone through their wombs also, and it was connected directly when the baby was in the mother's womb, and some emotional discord was there between the mother and the family, and all those emotions got stored in the baby. The baby started attracting or absorbing those emotions. And even you can see the bipolar disorders also, they either have these hormones which are either fluctuating or very low, and the psychological health is influenced by these critical hormones and glands in the body. And the lower levels of these hormones, that is the serotonin or the melatonin, is we are the hormones which are made by the pineal gland. It's a, like I said, it's a small gland in the brain. It's somewhere situated here. This diagram doesn't show you, but it's somewhere here. And this is the hippocampus which stores all the emotions. So these need to be regularly cleaned. All the courses that I do, my entire focus is on healing the mind and the brain, because if I heal this, it stores a lot of emotions. Once a person is free from all the emotions, that's where he can start connecting with his inner awareness or inner consciousness. But unless this is not clear, how he will connect with his own realities or the higher or the awakened levels of this consciousness. So I would always advise people that work on the mind, brain, and clearing all these emotional parts first. Because the brain has various sections which stores these emotions. And it starts, if it's not removed, and many a times I've done the auras of the people where I have seen in certain areas they start depositing, and there are patches which form in the body. That means the energy in that part is stuck. That means the potential energy or the potential messages that are coming in the brain or from the brain and through your neurotransmitters are not of higher vibrations. If higher vibrations would have been there, those patches would have not existed. Okay, that means the energy in the body is not flowing properly. The emotions are blocking the flow of your energy. Okay. So emotions are stored. And the hippocampus also plays a part in consciousness by shaping the conscious or the declarative thinking, that is meditative learned responses from the past associations and with the incoming sensory data. Incoming sensory data means whatever is happening in your background or the environments or whatever is being given to you and whatever you absorb. If you have the strongest level of mind, or if you have the highest level of mind that you are using, that is your subconscious and the superconscious level, you will never absorb the conscious way of how the people express or how which way they throw the emotions. Your filters will be very strong, that these will not allow those negative emotions to come, because you are always aware, you are always in the state of consciousness, and you are always catching the messages that are being delivered to you. That means you are in an awakened state. Like yesterday evening I was just directed to a place, and it was a nice movie. It was called Captain America. I love watching movies, and in fact when I entered after the movie had started, and it also focused on this hippocampus. The start of the movie starts from hippocampus, and there is that Mr. Stark who has this higher levels of intellectualness, and he has those ways where he builds all those gadgets and all that. But it also emphasized two, three strong messages that came to me, because those were connected with some of my emotions. And some ascended masters, their name was Bas and Sekhmet. They belong to the Egyptian gods and goddesses. See, if my emotions would have been not balanced, I would have not got these images which was just there in the movie. And during those states of my consciousness, I actually captured those messages, and actually I was redirected to that movie. The movie was actually a thriller movie, and we can just watch it just like that. But because of the consciousness and awareness part, I could actually capture those messages which were given to me. Okay. And because the emotions are balanced, it's not about being feeling very low or feeling very sad and depressed. This will hold me down. It will not allow my brain to perform very actively, and it will not allow me to receive those messages which are actually meant for me. It will show the low frequency of the brain. And how it will be captured is, see, even the PET, the PET scan also, you can see the different images here, that before meditating and after meditating, or after, before depression and after the recovery from the depression, how it has helped you. How even the brain shows different ways of energy, of how it is reflecting. A depressed brain will show a shrunken part, or the earlier part also we saw that there were very various holes in that. And if you see this brain and that brain is more balanced. It's showing less of darker colors and more of vital colors. You can see more of vitality has come here, and less of the depressed part has reduced. Okay, so neuroscience also informs of this reality. Brain scans done with PET imaging equipment shows that when a person meditates, there is a lot of activity which is triggered. Okay? So meditation is very, very necessary, and the prefrontal cortex lies in the same general area of the third eye. So which we believe a lot in the awakening of the third eye, and there are a lot of workshops which say that we do the activization of the third eye and activization of the DNA. I would advise, please don't go very fast in this, go very, very slow, and go at a speed that your consciousness can accept that, because if that is activated and the emotions are not healed, you will start having different levels of problems and different levels of emotional problems. So I would say that first clear your emotions before you activate this, and it's a natural process. If you surrender to the divine, this will automatically happen. So don't try to do something, let it naturally happen. Okay? The brain research informs us that people who regularly meditate actually physically involve the brain. Brain structures with neural changes that promote higher consciousness. Okay? And the frontal area, the orbifrontal area is also an area of the brain that lights up the brain scans when the meditation and the visualization occurs. So each activity that you do, now if your emotions are on a higher level, then it will activate those parts of the brain and start emitting those frequencies. So it will actually help you to balance your mind, it will actually help you to balance your body also. Because it's said that the brain is like a hard disk and the mind is like a software. So what you put inside is going to come outside. So if you put a depression or a very stressed up thoughts inside you, and if it's not removed from time to time, then it will start only emitting those images and those situations, and those problems will start coming to you again and again and again. Then, that's why we need to meditate. We can meditate minimum starting from 10 to 15 minutes, or maybe who are regular meditators who like to meditate for hours and hours, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. It can help you to balance and both the sides of your brain, and actually what we require is a balance between the both, that is the left and the right side, both should be balanced. So just like how the tarazu is balanced, or the weighing scale is balanced, you need to balance the both sides. The emotions aspect, the logical and the creative, both need to be balanced. Okay? And this is where our emotions will be stored, that various sections of the brain contribute these various emotions and their functions. So you can see the various part of the brain. Like this, it's said that there are more than 36 parts or 72 parts where these emotions will be stored. Okay, there are various healing modalities who focus on these different parts of the brain, or wherever these sections are there. And if you highlight that, and if you give healing energies means to give life force or prana to that part where the energy is stuck. These will start slowly releasing, and the releasing part is very, very essential. The certain parts of the brain, they govern specific functions. The cerebellum is involved in the coordination, the hippocampus with the memory. I just shared with that fact that it contains those part of your memories which, if are on a lower frequency, can hamper your present state of consciousness. So it needs to be cleared. And because the nerve cells, the neurons connect the area of the brain to one another. So the entire, the neurotransmitters which are passed on to our body through, which connect with our nervous system, with our skeletal system, everywhere that same messages go. So if my potential information in my brain cells, my master cell, is very, very wrong, the entire body will reflect that. But if I clear that one potential cell, the entire messages in my body, wherever there is pain, like it's a knee pain, or if it's a chronic pain, or if it's any other type of pain, it will start slowly healing. Because what I released was the emotional aspect of that memory. If I release that emotion, or I change the frequency of an emotion from a low to a high one. Have any questions here? And again, the human aura carries the same thing. We have 7 auric layers. There are many auric layers beyond this, but majorly we deal with the 7 layers of your aura, which have various emotions which are stored in various levels. There's a physical body. This is a physical body. After that, there's an etheric body. Then there is an emotional body, then there is a mental body, then there is a causal body, and these are the higher auric levels. Like I've seen many auras of the people, there are good energies in the outer aura, but the inner aura is very, very constricted. It is very, very shrunken, you know, the immediate negativity lies in this inner aura layers. That's where you can absorb it. Either it's come from your past life cognitive memories, it's there and your soul has got it, or it is there from the present. Not every problem exists from your past. Many a times have told that even if you start doing an inventory of your present life itself, see your childhood, what has happened. You know, many a times if you see that childhood patterns, you will find many of the problems, emotional problems that you are having right now, even relationship issues, will have history in that childhood only. You can actually do that inventory and many of the problems you will start finding it there. It was started, you know, it was a seed which was born there, and then later on it was not healed or it was not given a proper direction, it became a very big problem. So not everything belongs to the past lives, but there are some problems which, you know, require a past life understanding or a very higher states of consciousness to understand why certain things are coming repeatedly again, and that's where the karma will play a very big role. But with an higher states of consciousness, you can even transcend that. Like in my earlier lectures, I had given an example that there was a Q&A session of Shri Shri Ravi Shankar, and someone had asked him that, can we clear all the karma and emotions in this world of all the past lives that we have led? Can we clear that? He just gave a very beautiful answer in one line that, like if a room is shut for 20 years, how many days, how many months will you take to clear that room? It will take you maximum of 1 week, 2 days, 3 days, or 1 month, won't take much than that. So similar ways you can clear all your karmas and all your emotions in this life itself. The journey starts by present and start. You need to start somewhere. You find a guru. There are sometimes in your consciousness you get a guru. Okay, it's not a physical guru. Okay, in your meditation also you will find gurus, because there are lot of ascended masters who are there, allow our consciousness to shift from third dimension to fourth dimension, and from fourth to fifth. Those who have already entered into a fourth dimensional shift, their consciousness, I've seen many people whose consciousness shifted and their emotions are healed in such a way that they are shifting to a fourth dimension. So there these ascended masters play a very big role, and they allow you to shift from fourth to fifth dimensional shift. The major role the masters are playing, one of them is Mahavatar Babaji, the other one is even Krishna consciousness, and then there are many devis and shaktis who are playing the roles, because we are a part of this very strong Kali Yuga where the negative emotions are more powerful than the positive. So you need to transcend these negative emotions and you need to heal to get into these altered states, and when you start emitting a higher emotional frequencies, then you will see all these masters will start coming in. Like I just gave this example of a movie. If I want, I can just watch it like a movie. But I just entered that and started with the hippocampus, and I had already made that slide yesterday in the afternoon. It validated that importance that yes, I'm going on a right path. I need to highlight that, because that's where even your pineal gland will be connected. And if you start healing your brain and your mind, that's where the emotions will go. Because unless you're not empty of the emotions, how you will connect with the higher aspect of your soul? Because your emotions will always try to pull you down. It will always try to create situations, and it will try to restrict your time more on a higher productiveness and try to get you stuck with the problems. So it is very, very important. And again, ascended masters will play a very, very big role. I'll give an example that I was meditating. I had just taken my session. It was a 5-hour session, and after that I normally meditate for like 1 hour or 2 hours. And I was sitting in my meditation session, and I had built an altar of Mahavatar Babaji, which was just in front of me. And he just told me that, sit in front of me, I need to give you some messages. And he gave me really very good messages, and it was almost, in the month of February, so it's almost 2.5 months. And he gave me the entire curriculum of what I need to do. And I was earlier associated with some organization, and then immediately after that, I started working on my own. I mean, I started my own ways of doing researches, my own courses, my own seminars, workshop, everything on my own. And he actually gave me that curriculum downloaded in my unconscious mind. an unconscious mind is always not connected with the past, it is also connected with the present, where a lot of divine messages will be downloaded. And just yesterday I realized that so much was downloaded. All the curriculum what I needed to give it to people was already downloaded 2 months back. And it also, one more incident that I want to share. I had shared it in one of my lectures, but I still want to share it, that I had gone to a place called as Rishikesh, which is very close by to the Himalayas. And there also I connected with a higher aspect of me, and that was where my inner reality was connected. But I would have had emotions at that time. It would have not allowed me to connect at that higher aspect of the reality, where I would just share it now because I'm allowed to share it. Earlier I was not allowed to share it. I just got an indication that yes, you can share it. Is I was sitting and meditating in a place. It was nice. There is this place is called Dayanand Saraswati Ashram, and there was a nice temple, Shiva temple, and I was directed to meditate near that idol of Shiva. It was 12 avatars of Shiva, and I was told to meditate there. And I went there, I meditated there. I think I was there in trance for almost like 1 hour. When I went into trance, I immediately connected, and I saw the entire place was changed. It was not what is shown as a reality. It was something which is there connected with my inner reality. And I saw many sages who were sitting there and meditating. It was maybe they were meditating for 100, 200 years. That was their deepest level of consciousness, where I saw that what reality, what we are and I am right now is not the reality. That reality is something different. I belong to a different level of consciousness. And the masters are telling me, connect with that level of consciousness. You are now clear of emotions. You are now clear of the emotional aspect of that binding. Like just you said in the start, there is a word called as binding and there is a word called as bonding. You are connected with the bonding part now, not with the binding part. So your emotional aspect of that part is clear. Now you can see a higher picture. Now you can see that in that trance, you can see a lot of sages who are meditating, and they are trying to give you message. What you are doing is not your reality. Shift from that reality. You are made for a bigger picture. You are not made for just ordinary consciousness or awareness. You are made for a bigger picture. And if you walk on that step, it will take you to a very high dimensional shift. What we talk about ascended masters. And then today, I have seen that a lot of ascended masters are working very, very closely with me. I connect with a lot of people who have done courses or workshops from different organizations, but they still connect with me. So that is where the inner guru starts then guiding that yes, now you need to connect with different consciousness. It's not required to just connect with one guru. You can connect with many, many gurus. And the human aura carries all those emotions in different layers. So even having a very good aura or a good energy field is going to help you to have a better emotional feeling. And this is a message that I got very strongly when I just described this, is don't force yourself to fit in where you don't belong. And I just wanted to explain it to you because many a times you will also experience some situations in your meditations or awareness or consciousness which will try to give you the real blueprint of your life, what you are made up of. You are made for some different thing, and what life you are living is a different thing. Like the movie example that I gave to Tamasha, when he becomes clear of his blueprint, he actually goes to what he's supposed to do. So don't fit in yourself where you really don't belong. So you can break that. And the first step starts with that is breaking your comfort zones. And here your emotions will play a very big role. Okay. And I always follow Osho also. So he's also someone who guides me whenever required. Is be, don't lie to become. It's one line. You need to understand that is a very powerful message. Be, don't try to become what you are not. She is my divine mother. She is Ma Durga. So very beautiful message she gives me, and she's always connected. And many lives I have worshipped her, and through my inner reality, she's always connected with me. And the form came to me many years back. It's almost since last 10 to 12 years I started connecting with this inner reality. It came to me earlier, but at that time my emotions were not very balanced, not very clear. And it took me like 10 years to come to a level that now I accepted her as my divine mother. Earlier I used to worship her like God. I always wanted to worship Ma Durga as a God and someone like I need a form, but I don't need a form right now. Like in one of my meditation sessions, I experienced this awareness, like she just came in a golden form. Earlier it was a form, like how we see a Ma Durga, like with many hands, and she's capable of doing many things. But after some time, that form became nothing. It was just an energy which merged into my consciousness and all my senses, and all my brain cells started radiating it. So what we need to do is balance the emotions. And like you can see, the symbolic representation, you can see the Ma Durga has many hands. So you are made for many roles. In one life, you can escape all. And another way of emotional healing is also by keeping a lot of crystals with you, because crystals also talk. They also have frequencies which, when they connect with your inner frequencies, they heal you on a lot of internal levels. I always advise pure forms of crystals to use, that is a clear quartz, the amethyst, and the rose quartz. Now, rose quartz can heal you a lot with the emotional healing, and clear quartz can help you to remove all the negative blockages that you have, which highlight the flow of emotions in you. If you clear these blockages, the emotional flow starts slowly depleting, and you can carry your these crystals with you, or you can wear them, or you can place in the various parts of your room so that all the negativity gets absorbed in them, and you become less of emotional free, because wherever you go, you are surrounded by auras of people. If your aura is not very strong, you will start absorbing different frequencies of people, and these frequencies might have just ready-made emotions. Your aura is weak, you just caught up all those emotions, and then they slowly start coming into your consciousness. And various ways where how you can stop these crystals, I would strongly suggest that it should be there in every corners of your room. And there are various ways you can find the purest of it, crystals. And during your meditations also, you can keep these crystals, because they speak a lot, and various crystals have various functions which can help you with your emotional healing also. So this is also one aspect where you can heal your emotions by keeping the crystals. Rose quartz will help you to heal your relationship problems, or if you have being hurt, it will highlight the importance of and the aspect of love inside. Because peace is within, not outside, and good company can come in many forms. Now, I just got this message in my awareness that you do not need the company of people all the time, or relations to make yourself very good or to find peace. You can find that inside, or like you can see that it's a beautiful, this element is an elephant, he's a gigantic elephant, but he also has particles of love, he also has particles of consciousness, he also has particles of God within. So a good and God can come in many forms. And, start a day with a grateful heart. That's where you can heal a lot of your emotions, and because tomorrow never comes, and past never existed, whatever is there is to be. So utilize your energy in a right way. Okay? Try to clear your emotions daily. Don't wait for tomorrow, or don't wait for that today to become a past, for that or tomorrow to become a today. Heal it, whatever is there today. Whatever moments you have, don't create memories, just create moments. And try to heal those moments daily. Try to wash it out daily. Music is the essence of soul. Now, what type of music is very necessary? I like it. The best part of it is the rain. The rain has a music. How many people try to experience rain? The music that is have music that it has. I mean, try to record the music of the rain, and if you try to listen it and experience it, you will. You will experience a different release, because these are natural sounds. So this is the music that I am referring to, not the music that we normally listen. But those are also very good music. But try to connect with these aspects of music to heal your emotions. The rain sounds, the sound of the water, it is a natural healer which will help you to heal with your internal emotions.
Even the bird sounds.
Yeah, I'm coming to it. Actually, this is something you need to experience, the flow of the water or the sound of the rain. You need to record it, but nowadays it's already recorded and YouTube have many of these recordings, so you can actually download and experience that. Actually, because why? Water and that rain is because 70% of our body is made up of water element, so that can heal the water element. Then the sounds of the leaves or the sounds the trees have, you know, when they
wind passes.
Yes, and wind passes. So that's a kind of a nature's music merge inside it. You know, go to a place where you can see the trees swinging, you know. Even if your daily lives, you can see the trees are swinging, the wind is going. So you try absorbing that, because that music will connect with your inner part.
We don't have time to observe that and absorb it.
You do have time when you are traveling and when you are not driving.
That is why for second home and all this thing, we are going to learn how
to. You don't need to do that. See, in your daily life, you can find those moments when you are traveling. Or, you know, just sit at a place when you can find good nature and try to connect with that aspect of the nature. Because if at that point you are going through a lot of emotional trauma or emotional problem, that small thing what you did will help you to create awareness, and that can find you solution also. And the third part is like what you said, the birds who are chirping, you know, breathe with that. You can actually record these natural sounds and all, and you know, you can hear it when you are very depressed or sad, when you have a lot of emotions coming up, or actually meditate on this. I actually do that whenever I go to natural surroundings and when there is less of this traffic noises and all that, I record this and I hear it. And many of my guided meditations which I record, I incorporate this. And again, praying to the Lord and taking His help to clear your emotions. And telling the Lord or the Divine, what you call this, ignite the flame of my love with your essence. Because love is the greatest healer which can heal any of your emotions. If your heart chakra is expanded, you can forgive and forget everyone. The today's biggest problem where the emotions are not healing is of the unforgiveness. We are not ready to forgive people. If someone has hurt us, we make sure that either we give them you know, equal to equal or a revenge, or either come to a point that where these unforgiveness starts hampering us and we are not ready to release it, because these emotions will cause blockages in your body, it will cause pains in your body, not for anyone else but at least for yourself. Start releasing these emotions and start forgiving people, and the best way of forgiving people is doing it daily. At the end of the day, before you sleep, make sure you do this prayer, ignite the flame of my love with your essence, and before that just do the forgiveness for everyone. Even if someone has hurt you very badly, forgive them, because their unforgiveness will cause emotions in your body that will cause blockages in your body. So to release that and to ignite this flame of love, you need to forgive. Anyone who has hurt you more, please forgive them first. Because they will not be hampered, but their emotions will be stuck in your consciousness.
Another question, you are telling that so if the person continues harming up, then the person continues harming, continue harm kar rahe apne.
एक तो है कि आपका कर्मा का पार्ट है.
Okay.
But when you do this process continuously, when you come to a state of awareness and consciousness, कि वो जो भी कर रहा है ना, उसका आपको कोई फर्क ही नहीं पड़ता.
Okay, so because by that time,
not just your heart chakra has expanded, you are willing to forgive, you look at him as a divine child of God. And your willpower has become so strong that his saying all those things is not hampering your consciousness. It's not making difference to you. Kitna bhi bologe to aapko koi farak nahi padega.
Accept him as it is.
Yeah, accepting the situation as it is actually reduces the impact of that emotions on you. कितना भी नेगेटिविटी वो आपके दे रहा है, उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज आई एम इन यू. लाइक व्हेन यू ब्रीथ, वी ऑलवेज से दैट द डिवाइन और द गॉड इज इन यू एंड यू आर इन मी. इट्स म्यूचुअल ऑलवेज. ओके, इट्स डिवाइन लव एंड दिस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट हीलर. एंड आई एम इन डिवाइन लव. व्हेन यू बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस, यू बिकम अ पार्ट ऑफ द यूनिवर्सल कॉस्मिक कॉन्शियसनेस, वेयर the emotions will not play a very big role. It will be automatically healed when you surrender to the divine. You no longer have to find ways or means of healing where you need to artificially remove this. Yes, initially you may have to start it, but when you surrender to this aspect of divine, it is an auto mode healing. They take care of you because you are their divine child. Even the breath is merged in God. The God is never different. You don't require a form to worship, or you don't require anything. You start becoming your own guru. You will reach at a point in your life where you will start becoming your own guru. At that point, you will not require anything. Till that, you will require. This is where the universal cosmic consciousness will be born. I wish that everyone on this earth will ignite their consciousness and clear their emotions in a way that this universal cosmic consciousness, where we need to radiate ourselves to the beam of light, will start pouring in us. And that's where the universal cosmic love will come, where we don't see ourselves as a human body, but we see ourselves as a beam of light, connected. You can see the connections are always on the heart chakra. We'll be connected to each and every one on the heart-to-heart level. That's the ignition of our soul. And that's where our soul starts speaking. So this is called as universal cosmic love. That's where all the higher aspects of your soul will come. That is the highest, what you call as the higher self. There are many times that your ego self will stop from connecting with your higher self. Your ego self will be connected with your emotions. So once you start disconnecting with your ego self, you will connect the highest and the purest aspect of you, that is called as your higher self. That is the purest aspect of your soul which does not have any emotions. Like, I'll just share an example with you. I was contemplating on certain decisions, and it was happened in my dream state only, and I was asleep, and I saw the two aspects of me. I was not a physical body or anything. It was just an interview dialogue. I saw my soul, and I saw my higher aspect of the soul, that is my higher self, and they were discussing the decision that I need to take. And I was just an observer. I was just looking. I was not looking, but I was just connecting with the interview messages. And there was a kind, not conflict, but there was a debate between the two souls. And both of them mutually agreed. Finally, they had a debate, and I was just witnessing this drama, what was happening. And I clearly remember what both of them had to say. And finally, my soul, which was had maybe some parts of the ego, finally left that and merged with the higher self and agreed what was the highest decision which was made for the highest good of everyone. That means I was just a witness observing it. The lower self or the lower soul did not try to debate it. It just tried to accept. That means on that soul level only I got healed. And those emotions and the ego which was stopping, it just went off. And the higher self messages just came.
Yes, our others are connected, the central man is connected.
Mm. We are connected with each other through heart chakras. The emotions bind us on various levels. That is why even the cord cutting needs to be done. When you are doing healings on higher levels, that is to increase your consciousness, you need to regularly do the cord cuttings, because each and every person is connected to each other through emotions. Like a mother and son is connected with emotions. Or a husband and wife, they are connected with the emotions. The brother, sister, everyone is connected with the cords of emotions. And these emotions, if they are not cleared, if they have very low frequencies, they are connected with various parts of our body. Various parts of the body start reflecting those emotions in the form of pain, in the form of injury, or in the form of diseases like cancers or tumors, because these emotions have not been released. But these are the higher cosmic universal connections which we are connected each other to heart chakras. Like recently I started connecting with various followers of Babaji. So we are like, something like this. We know our roles, what we need to play. We are connected with our inner realities. We don't know each other on human levels. It's just that the higher source or the ascended masters are trying to connect with us. It's like a round table conference. And all these people are slowly connecting with me, and we are being given a role to create awareness. So slowly this will start connecting and this will happen on these levels. You may know the person, you may not know the person. But we have transcended the aspect of emotional being. Then only it will happen. And this will come in the divine plan. And the aspect of Shiva, that is the stillness, will open in you. The third eye will open in you. And various ascended masters who are there for the healing of love, you can invoke them to heal your emotions. She is the Mother Mary. And the guardian angels who can help you and guide you. The other ones are Jesus. He teaches you to develop love and compassion. So many of the times these ascended masters, when I do the angel guided sessions, they are there. I can, I don't see them in the physical forms. Their energies I can recognize. And he teaches us to develop love and compassion, being non-judgmental, and to highlight the Christ self and the mighty I am. I am is a very strong word which is connected with the divine. And she is Mary Magdalene, and she is supposed to be said to be the wife of Christ, Jesus. And she can support you in every way. The way she can be become like your personal guide or your friend, just like Mother Mary, she is also like your friend. So you can actually talk with them. You don't need to have a figure of them in front of you. You can speak with their energy, because when you invoke them through the flame of love, they will just come close to you and they will show you signs also. Like just yesterday I got a sign of those two angels that they were trying to, and just 1 week back they had already connected with me and they were trying to give me some messages, this past and some sacred Egyptian symbols were just coming to me in my consciousness. So it just validated that importance or that validation that yes, they are there. And, Paul the Venetian, you can call these ascended masters, and he can help you. He's devoted to the beauty and perfection of the soul through patience and understanding, self-discipline and the development of intuitive and creative faculties of heart. So a lot of intuitive and creative things can start developing in you. A lot of talents can start coming in you. And she is always my favorite ascended master, and she is very, very close to me, always connected with my heart chakra. She is the Kuan Yin, and her mantra is Om Mani Padme Hum. You can see she is the goddess of mercy, love and compassion. So if you are looking for an emotional healing, and you can invoke them also. You. She's a very loving, and she is projected in a pinkish violetish color. So in your consciousness, when you see these colors, you know that you have connected with them. And the food of your soul is, follow this, is live the moment, don't live memories. Love the moment and laugh at the moment, because many a times these movements will create very strong memories for you, and if at times you can rely on these memories if you have feeded your soul in the right way, if you have given the right food to your soul. The aspect is your inner dialogue or your inner conversation has to be very, very clear. If you could write a note to your younger self, what would you say? How would you describe your own self? That's where your inner child comes in picture. You know, how good is your inner child, or how well do you pamper your own self? Pampering doesn't mean by having a lot of money and having a lot of shopping, but there are various ways that you can describe your inner self, that is your inner child.
Actually, that is most important.
Yeah.
Before contacting with higher masters and all these things, we should talk to ourselves. That is the first basic.
That will happen when you start meditating.
Yes.
Somewhere you have to start, but I always say that no pain, no gain. If even if you have some problems in your life, there's a lot of emotional pain, there's a lot of mental trauma, take it as an opportunity to transcend that reality and come into a different world. So you can actually write and check out what is your internal dialogue. It's very, very important. Take a time out and write a note to yourself and see what words you are using for yourself. Then always say divine prayers, because see, for God you are a divine child. You are not like someone who is very old or someone who is very small. He is equal. equal, you are equal to the God, and everyone is equal. So when you do the prayers, divine prayers, you become like a child. You know, you can have that aspect of you. You don't need to be very big to, you know, express the divine prayers to the God. You can be like a child. You can have childlike prayers also. It's very, very important. And Krishna is ascended master, the healer of the inner child. So you can see his childhood also, Krishna's, which is depicted in a lot of serials also. We have seen the Krishna's childhood. It's full of joy. It's full of masti, you know. So the inner child also needs to be healed. It's very, very important. Okay, because we look at the various aspects of healing, but we do not look at our inner dialogue. You know, we want to do this course, we want to do that. But main thing what I tell people is look at your inner dialogue. What is that? And you realize that what emotions you want to give, you can work only on those. And then your soul will guide you what's good for you and what's important for you. Then is love, nature, God and me. Like, you see these images, it's a very beautiful image. Like, everything is just merged. You don't see anything that's different. There is no play, there is only stillness. The background is also very, very merged inside. The human is also very merged inside. So when you connect with this aspect of you, the emotions don't stay. And that happens when you are in the aspect of stillness, when you are connected with your own reality. And you can either experience time through your inner reality, that is by your inner consciousness of who you are, rather than experiencing who you are through your power center, that is your Manipura center, experience who you are through your heart center, and that will connect you with the highest consciousness of your, that is your higher self. Or time will attach you to karma and destiny. That's where the emotions will play a very big role here, because every birth it will keep on carrying and carrying and carrying in all your cells. It will be there in your nucleus, it will be connected with your DNA, and all your genes will start having these emotions and all these negative frequencies, and that's where it will attach you to karma and destiny. So you need to transcend beyond that, because eyes capture the details of every emotions. It's stored in as memories in sections of your brain, which acts as a hard disk. So you need to clear these directly from your brain. So the mind brain healing from the part where it stores memory is very, very important, and that's where you will be permanently free from the memory of that emotion. And lighting the light for someone will ignite your eternal flame. So that's also very higher aspect of it. If you love helping people, if you're lighting a lamp for someone, no sooner it will also ignite your eternal light. That is, it will expand the consciousness of your heart chakra. If your heart chakra is expanded, the gateway to the higher consciousness is always open. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
It was a very short talk. And these are my email IDs and WhatsApp number. Any of the queries that you have, you can always email me. And this WhatsApp number is for, if you want, you can WhatsApp me on this number. I will add you to my broadcast groups. Every day I spread consciousness messages through that. It's more of for my updates and for my consciousness messages. All the communication can be done on my email ID. So I can add you. I have more than 800 people who are there on my